thing I found immediately about playing the stage vantage was, from a guy that's not a technical person, I don't want to spend a lot of time trying to reinvent the wheel here. Korg has a very good track record of coming up with great sounds to begin with. But it's beyond that. They have things that you can as you're playing and touch these things rather quickly, the little buttons that move a sound into a chorus, or they take it off, or they give you a little more click, or you can smooth it out. You can throw an amp sound on it. It bolsters the sound, gives you more punch for soloing. And then you can pull it back, say if you're in the chorus and you want something a little smoother. I mean, that's what we want as a player, is easy access. And you also want to have an instrument that drives your imagination. And this thing really does that. I think the Stage Vintage is a good axe on all those levels. And it speaks in a language that I've been speaking for a long time. I'm a vintage guy. This is a vintage keyboard. As a guy to start off playing acoustic piano, I really got into the idea of using sostenuto pedal and then being able to bring things way up in volume if I needed it. It's unusual to have an electric keyboard or synth have that dynamic range. So for my style of playing, which really requires to complete and have a great conversation on stage, I want something that I can move in rather quickly, and this instrument really does it. It's dynamically, it doesn't really get much better than this. There's an upright piano on this that's really suited for rock and roll piano, for example. But that's not the only language I speak as a musician, and probably you don't either. So, you know, I just want something I can click a dial a couple places and I'm there. Because sometimes you, even within the context of a song, you might want to have a change of texture. With an instrument like this, with the Stage Vintage, it provides that, again, easy access for you. I don't see how you could do any better. What the Stage Vintage has is some great organ sounds, and there's some I'm really familiar with. Actually, a few that, to be honest with you, I haven't thought of in a long time. And for those that love Frank Zappa and remember El Monte's Legion Stadium, they got that vibe in there too. And you know what? I'm glad to have all this stuff back. I'm mesmerized by this instrument, just looking at the array of things on it. But I got to tell you something. the coolest thing about this axe is whatever you're playing, it actually sounds real. And I think that's a really cool quality. And you can throw it into an amp, although you have an amp, the amps are already in here. But you can do whatever you want with it, but the bottom line is what these folks have developed is something that is taken from real instruments. And you could sit here and A-B them, but you'd have to like to have 5 to 10, 20 instruments to choose from. It's the real deal. It is absolutely the real deal. What I'm looking for in a keyboard is something that feels great, great touch, great feel, great sounds, stage vintage. Everything else aside, the instrument looks great. It's vintage, as it should be. Kind of a Jetsons thing here with the little dials and stuff. Great combination. I really like it. I always encourage people that love music to come out and hear Little Feet. I've been in this band for 40 years. I've got an instrument that has a lot of the sounds I've used over the last 40 years. I'm going to proudly play them on stage with Feet and whomever else I'm asked to play with. So come on out and hear me, hear this instrument, and enjoy yourselves. Play from my heart. Little Feet is one of those bands that really speaks to a lot of musicians and to a lot of people. This is a voice we use as the instruments we're given, and I've never really had a chance to thank Korg for giving me that voice to add to my voice, and this is yet another really, really cool instrument which allows me to do that. And it's going to be a pleasure and honor to play it.